Okay, dear students, we are discussing about environmental issues. Our topic name is environmental issues. Yesterday we have started environmental issues. Environmental issues. We are trying to complete this topic in today and tomorrow. Okay, environmental issues, whatever surroundings, wherever we are living. Okay, not only we animals and wildlife plants, whatever is the wildlife animals, whatever is that their surrounding, what type of problem they are facing, what type of issues is their environmental issues. So yesterday already we started the topic environmental issues. In environmental issues, what we are discussing yesterday? Yesterday we discussed about generally environment surroundings are facing the problem of pollution. Okay, yesterday we learned about the definition of what pollution, definition of pollution, which are called pollutants. Pollutants is nothing but the causing factors of pollution. Okay, what we call causing factors of pollution. Causing factors we can call pollution. Causing factors of pollution we can call pollutants. And pollution means already we know undesirable, unwanted or toxic, undesirable, unwanted and toxic materials are enter into the environment is called, that is we can call especially for pollution. Undesirable, unwanted, poisonous or toxic material, waste materials are entering into the atmosphere. Okay, it is changing the composition of atmosphere. Composition of environment, that is we can call especially for, okay, that is pollution. Generally pollution is three types. Okay, so many types of pollution is there. Generally the main types of pollution is what? Air pollution, soil pollution and water pollution, and also we are going to discuss about the noise pollution also, little bit about noise pollution also. So yesterday already we started about air pollution. So air in atmosphere, air pollution. Okay, first of all we learned about the atmosphere. What is atmosphere? Atmosphere acts as a blanket. Okay, just acts as a blanket. It protects from UV blanket. It protects from ultraviolet rays. Okay, it protects from ultraviolet rays. It protects from temperature. The atmosphere, whatever the above the surface of the earth, whatever air level, gases we can call atmosphere, that gases protect from ultraviolet rays, temperature, it is a reflect the sunlight especially for, so it is a protect as a blanket. So that is we can call especially for thermoregulators also. It is a controlling what regulate the temperature is also, which control atmosphere controls what temperature is also. So why? Because it is control the temperature, means what? It is reflecting, it is sending back whatever, okay, temperature, whatever sunlight is entered into the earth. Okay, it is not totally not entered. So it is a protect as a blanket, it acts as a blanket, and also it controls the thermoregulator. That means temperature is also, it will be controlled. So we learned, okay, what we learned in air, different types of gases is there. Nitrogen 78.059 and oxygen 0.89% and argon and xenon and carbon dioxide also is there. Carbon dioxide percentage is 0.03% is there in carbon dioxide. After that one, what we learned? We learned about the causes of air pollutants. Already I am told air pollutants means air pollutants. The meaning of pollutants means what? Which are causes of pollution we can call air pollutants. Air pollutant, what we discussed in the first one is very important, poisonous carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides, NO, NO3, whatever is the nitrogen oxides, and also aerosols are particulate matters. This is the word we can call particulate matter, that is we can call especially for. And also how to control especially for air pollution also we are not going to discuss it right now. Okay, already we did learned about what carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is a dangerous, it is the automobiles, especially for fossil fuels. Okay,
fossil fuels are releasing carbon monoxide. Already we discussed, so that I will go very fast. Carbon monoxide is the very dangerous air pollutant. It is releasing automobile, unburnt fossil fuels. Unburnt meant what? Not completely burned what fossil fuels, like what petrol, diesel, kerosene, or whatever is there. And it is releasing carbon monoxide, especially automobiles. It is releasing carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide, very important point. It is more FEVD. Already I am explaining what is the meaning of FEVD. Compared with oxygen, carbon monoxide, very, very important. Carbon monoxide is more affinity with what? Hemoglobin. It combined and form carboxyhemoglobin. Carboxyhemoglobin. This is we can call carboxyhemoglobin. Okay, when the carboxyhemoglobin, high concentration of carboxyhemoglobin, so that if in air, high concentration, carbon monoxide is high concentrate, it is cause of coma, that means brain damage, coma, and sometimes it cause of death also. But it is less concentrated, sometimes it is less concentrated in environment, atmosphere. When it is in less concentrated, it cause of what? It's cause of headache. It cause of headache and also what? Body pains and also nausea, vomitings. Okay, so small, and respiratory problems. Respiratory, just like asthma. Okay, called asthma. Asthma, who are the asthma patient? Very difficult to respire. So, carbon monoxide is very dangerous. We can call carbon monoxide poisoning. Very, very important in examination. So many times asking, what is carbon dioxide poisoning? The carbon dioxide poisoning means what? The carbon dioxide, when it is entered into the blood, in blood hemoglobin, it is more affinity with hemoglobin. It is transported throughout the body. It is cause of death. Actually, it is cause of death and coma. So carbon dioxide is a very, carbon monoxide is a very dangerous, air pollutant. So you have to remember whatever the point given here. And death and coma and also headache and also little bit asthma also cause of what? Based on the concentration of carbon monoxide. So after carbon monoxide, what we discussed? After carbon monoxide, we discussed about what? Carbon dioxide. Already we know who are secreting, producing carbon dioxide, CO2. Carbon dioxide is what produced by what? Especially for even animals, all animals are releasing carbon dioxide, and plants also releasing carbon dioxide in the process of respiration, and also and unburning what? Especially for burning fuels also releasing what? Burning fuels. And industry is also releasing carbon dioxide. How carbon dioxide is more dangerous to us? It is a air pollutant. Sir, how can you say carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide is very important to the plants. It is very important to the plants to process of photosynthesis. But if the carbon dioxide is percentage is increasing, it is a cause of what? The carbon dioxide having one character. What character is there in carbon dioxide? It absorbs. What it absorbs? It absorbs more sunlight. It is trapping. The word you have to use, trap the sunlight. When the carbon dioxide percentage is increasing in atmosphere, it is trapping more sunlight. It is indirectly cause of greenhouse effect. And not only greenhouse effect, and also cause of what? Global warming. When the greenhouse is increasing the temperature, it is a cause of what? Global warming. We'll discuss about later what is the separate about global warming, but especially for carbon dioxide is cause of greenhouse effect and also what? Global warming. So many times in examination they are asking one question. What type of question? In animals and plants are releasing in the process of respiration, that gas is cause of what? Global warming or greenhouse effect. That gas is, which gas is that is? That is carbon dioxide only. So you have to remember that point. After that one, carbon dioxide, what we are discussing? We discussed about what? Sulfur dioxide. Next one is sulfur dioxide. If you observe the sulfur dioxide, how sulfur dioxide affecting? Especially for sulfur dioxide, SO2. SO2 is also very dangerous. Why? Because it is dangerous. SO2, SO2 indirectly is cause of acid rains.
in examination. It is the one of the substance when the SO2 and nitrogen oxides, NO or NO2, whatever it is, SO2 and nitrogen oxide, these two are causes of what? Nitrogen oxides. These two are causes of what? Especially for what? Acid rains. Okay, what are the damage of, already we learned yesterday. Okay, what are the damages of SO2? SO2 means what? Especially historical monument, damage, corrosion. We can call, I'm giving the point corrosion. Corrosion means what? It is a marble cancer also. We can call marble cancer. For example, SO2 is the cause of what? Marble cancer. What is the meaning of marble cancers? Marble cancers means what? The changing the marble color. Okay, which is changing the marble color? SO2 changing the marble color. That is, we can call marble cancers. Marble cancer, for example, Taj Mahal. First of all, Taj Mahal, it is a white in color, the marbles are white in color. Later, it is changing its yellowish color. The reason of what? SO2, acid rains. So, acid rains are very dangerous. Okay, acid rains are very dangerous. Okay, so, okay, here you have to remember. The carbon sulfur dioxide has the burning of fossil fuels, melting of sulfur ores, and also melting of what? Metal meltings, releasing what? Especially for sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide, asthma patient and cardiovascular problems. Okay, it is making the problem to asthma patients, and also not only asthma patients, it is also cause of what? Especially for cardiovascular problem, heart problems also, cardiovascular problems, okay, problems. So you have to remember Taj Mahal, especially for changing the marble color, and also historical monuments, whatever historical monuments is there, it is changing the color of what? Sulfur dioxide. So sulfur dioxide is produced by what? Unburned, especially for sulfur dioxide, and produced by fossil fuels, unburning fossil fuels, melting of sulfur ores, and also melting of what? Metals. It is sulfur dioxide is secreted. After sulfur dioxide, one more cause of air pollution, that is, we can call nitrogen oxides, NO, NO3, NO4, whatever is there. Nitrogen oxides also indirectly cause of air pollution. Okay, nitrogen oxides are pollution cause of acid rains and formation of photochemical smoke. So, NO, NO3, whatever is it? So that you are writing in nitrogen oxides are the cause of acid rains and photochemical smoke. What is the meaning of smoke? Smoke means what? Okay, water vapor with what? Especially emulsion, whatever smoke releasing. Smoke plus water vapor. That is smog. We can call smoke. Okay, here if you observe it, that acid and nitrogen oxides are the causes of what? Acid rains and also what? Photochemical smoke. Nitrogen oxides affects plants, reduce photosynthesis. It reduces photosynthesis. It reduces photosynthesis, and also not only photosynthesis, and reduce the crop yield. Automatically, when they are reducing the photosynthesis, it reduces crop yield, reduce the crop yield, and also what? Necrotic spots. This is very important. Necrotic spots on the leaf, on surface of the leaf, on surface of the leaf. So here, nitrogen oxides also, especially for releasing some industries and factories and burn, okay, especially for fossil fuels are secreting, producing what? Nitrogen oxide. These nitrogen oxide is the causes of acid rains and photochemical smoke. Okay, photochemical smoke. Smoke means smoke plus water vapor.
And next one, reduce, it is damage, it reduces the photosynthesis, it reduces the crop yield, and also necrotic spots. What is the meaning of necrotic spots? If you observe the leaf, on the surface of the leaf, generally, it is a cause of some spots. Just like the spots are visible, this is a necrotic spots, the causes of what, especially for nitrogen oxide. Nitrogen acts as a primary pollutant and reacts, especially for nitrogen oxides produce primary pollutant. That secondary pollutant we can call PAM, secondary pollutant. It reacts with other chemicals and forms what? PAN, PAM. Okay, PAM is a what? Especially what is the meaning of PAM? Peroxyacetyl nitrate. PAN. PAN is a secondary pollutant of nitrogen oxide. Secondary pollutant as nitrogen oxide. PAN is formed in photochemical smoke. PAN is formed in photochemical smoke. So that PAN is what, especially for nitrogen oxides, also very dangerous. Especially for even in plants, it is the reducing the crop yield, and as human beings also, especially for it irritates respiratory tract and eyes. Irritation of respiratory tract and eyes. So, try to remember PAN, PAN is very, very important. That is, a PAN is nothing but we can call peroxy. Okay, peroxyacetyl nitrate. That is the secondary pollutant. Okay, which is formed by photochemical smoke, nitrogen oxides. After that one, already we discussed about what these are the causes of air pollutants. And last pollutant, I will write here the last pollutant. That is especially for aerosols or particulate matter. Aerosols and particulate matter, that is what particulate means, what solid matter. That is the solid matter and fly ash produced by thermal plants, forest fires, cement factories, asbestos mining, and also guinea mills. According to CPMB, Central for Pollution of Control Board, Central for Pollution, CCMB means what? CCCB, Pollution, Central for Pollution Control Board. As for them, which is called especially particulate matter, or we can call aerosols. Particulate matter is sizes less than 2.5 micrometer. The particulate size is less than 2.5 micrometer. That is called particulate. As per CPCB, Central for Pollution Control Board, CPCB, as per CPCB, which is called aerosols or particulate matter. Aerosols are particulate matter which is small in size, which is less than 2.5 micrometer. That is, we can call particulate matter. What is particulate matter? Don't confuse. If you observe or not, in cement industries, cement factories, if you observe in cement factories in locality, that area is totally covered with what? Gray color. Even houses are also covered with gray color. That means that cement particles, very dangerous, asbestos and cement, and also mining centers also, especially for that type of centers is there, where the marble centers, rock centers, cement, asbestos center, in that they are releasing small particles. That particles are also very dangerous. Why? Because it is cause of asthma, respiratory problem. It is sometimes it cause of what, cancers also. Sometimes some asbestos is also cause of cancers also. So, okay, here one important point we have to discuss. Are you understand what is particulate matter? Particulate matter means what? Nothing easy one, dust particles. Dust particles. In dust particles are so many times in India, in all roads are very clean. No. Okay, especially for if you observe that, so if you are going in outside, what will be happen? A lot of dust particles are entering into the body. It causes of respiratory problem, allergies, respiratory problems. That dust particles are entered. Okay, how to separate the dust particles? That is we have to discuss. They are using in some instruments, all industries are not using that instrument to separate particulate matter or aerosols. Aerosols are very dangerous to respiratory, it make the respiratory problem to the human beings. But actually they need to use some instrument to control what? Particulate matter. What they had to use? They had to use electrostatic precipitator. Very, very important. What they had to use? Electrostatic precipitator. Precipitator. What is the meaning? What is the meaning of electrostatic precipitator? This electrostatic precipitator separates, it observes what? It is a combined with whatever dust particles is there. Dust particles are, it is separated. It does not pollute the environment. It is separated what? Removing, just you have to remember, it is removing dust particles or particulate matter. Which instrument we are using? That instrument in the industry, they are using electrostatic precipitator. Okay, try to remember that one. After electrostatic precipitator and also some more measuring to control air pollution, some more instruments also they are using to control air pollution. Okay, measuring to control air pollution. What type of measure? What type? To control air pollution, to control air pollution, what they are using? One is already beyond electrostatic precipitator. In examination they are asking how to control aerosols, how to control what, how to control particulate matter by using electrostatic precipitator. Only electrostatic precipitator? No. Okay, to control, especially for catalytic converter. Catalytic, one more instrument, catalytic converter. How they are using the catalytic converter? In catalytic converter means what? These instrument they are arranging in vehicles. Vehicles means in automobiles. How to use this catalytic converter? Catalytic converter in olden days, maybe 15-20 years back and 10 years, more than 10-15 years back, in all vehicles, maybe two wheelers or four vehicles, releasing more smoke. Nowadays, if you observe or not, the vehicles are not releasing, not producing what, more smoke. Less smoke. In some vehicles are not producing smoke also. So reason is what? That smoke, whatever produced by burning fossil fuel, that smoke is also useful as a fuel if we arrange a catalytic converter. Catalytic converter are arranged in automobiles to convert whatever unburnt fossil fuels also, totally it converts as a fuel. So mileage also gives more mileage. The reason is what? Nowadays there are arranging catalytic converter, they are using whatever smoke, it is smoke is also converted as a fuel, catalytic converter, that is we can call. And that is a catalytic converter. And also one more you can call, and scrubbers, very, very important. Scrubbers actually in to control SO2. SO2 means what? Sulfur dioxide. especially for in thermal stations. Thermal station means producing what we call producing electricity. Thermal stations, especially in thermal station, there are using scrubbers. One more catalyst, one more instrument which is useful to control SO2. So SO2 particles are also controlled by one instrument which is arranged in thermal industries or thermal factories. They are using some instrument. That instrument name is scrubbers. Okay, try to remember three instrument names. One is electrostatic precipitator, which controls dust particles or aerosols or particulate matter. Second one is what we call catalytic converter. Catalytic converters are useful to control emission. Emission means what? Smoke. Emission of vehicles. That is useful as a fluid. It converts the as a fluid whatever smoke is also. Okay. It is next one, scrubbers means scrubbers are useful to control SO2 sulfur dioxide. So this is what information about what air pollution. Okay, air pollution. So air is also polluted with what? Some air pollutant, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and nitrogen oxide. Some points are very important in this. So you have to take down that points. Now we have to discuss about what noise pollution. Okay, now I will send the screenshot, then I will start what noise pollution. Okay, clear? Okay, I will send right now the screenshot, then we will going to start about noise pollution. Just a minute.